Jordy here for CineCam.net and welcome to Copycat Friday. This is a series where we recreate a video effect or film technique, and today we're having a look at Stranger Things. But first up, look at this! New t-shirt! This is our Copycat. Now we can all be like Eleven, a character from the series who can move objects by her mind. And because we are creative editors with Premiere Pro by our side, it's pretty simple. Before we start, I'd like to thank Videoblox for not only sponsoring today's episode, but also for being there for us at every new project. We have a year subscription that only costs $149 per year, and that gives us access to their huge video library. Now you can find stock videos, slideshow animations, backgrounds, light leaks, effects, and much more. There's no download limit, which makes its pricing actually super cheap. On top of that, you can even start a 7-day trial completely for free by following the first link in the description below. Our mind-controlling scene was created out of 3 shots. The first one was an empty shot. We'll be using this to remove other objects later on. And because we're going to blend 3 shots together, we need to film everything from a tripod. You can take multiple shots like we did in the opening, but every shot that will have a floating object needs to be taken from a tripod. Then the next take is where I lift up the knife with a wire. And you can use fishing wire here, but it's not necessary. With some tape on the back of the knife, I was able to secure the wire in place. And while I was doing this, I had a visible counter. When the counter hit 10 seconds, I dropped the knife. And this timing is important for the last shot. Here we have Janek starting his mind tricks. And as he starts, we also run the chronometer. Then meanwhile, I hold a second knife, or that same one, without a wire above him. When the counter hits 10, I drop the knife into Janek's hands. Make sure that you are somehow on the same position as where you let the knife fall in the previous shot. And that's all we have to do. Now we can bring everything inside Premiere Pro. The empty shot goes on the bottom. On top of that, the floating knife and Janek's Oscar-winning performance. We're going to remove the wire by going into the effects controls and under opacity, choosing the pen tool. This allows us to draw a mask around the knife, and you can do this pretty rough. The only point where it needs to be precise is at the wire itself. Next, you'll need to manually track the mask, so I'll enable the animation for the mask path. If you want it to be very precise, you need to change your path per frame you move forward. But we found out that it also works great by just skipping a few frames. If your mask is visible, then that's probably because of a lighting difference between your shots. By increasing the mask feather, you can remove that hard edge. So that's it for the knife! If everything went well, it should float beautifully in the sky right now. Next up is Janek, and since I'm standing in his shot holding that knife, the first thing that we'll do is draw a mask around Janek. And that will solo him and remove me from the scene. Of course, we want to make sure to cut off the mask beneath my hands. This mask will also feather a bit, not only to remove the hard edges, but also to make the transition of the falling knife better. Now align the two clips so that the lift off and fall of the knife comes together with Janek's reactions. And this is why we needed to have that timing so right. All is done now, but since everything was shot on a tripod, it looks pretty static. Luckily, we have a collection of 8 handheld camera movement presets, which you can download from our website for free, and I'll leave a link to it in the description below. Select all of your clips, right-click, and say Nest. And that will group all of those clips together, to which we can now apply any of the 8 different camera shakes to. And that's it! Thank you guys so much for watching again, and like always, stay creative!